The logging site was a mess. The modular office had been pushed off the cliff. Deputy Thornton climbed up from the wreckage excited, breathing hard from the exertion. Nobody there. It's weird. Don't you think that's weird? Bored, Mulligan let out a mighty snort. Hell, it's always weird, Thornton. Just a question of sorting out what kind of weird it is this time around. He saw the darkness attack the visitor center. It made him a believer. The men Al said he'd shot, they hadn't been just locals on crank. Somehow the world had changed, like the channel had been switched without warning. You think you're watching a sitcom and you're really watching a horror show. When the birds started attacking the cabin, Barry wasn't surprised, just terrified.
Occupation.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on. I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods. The FBI agent's command froze me in place. I considered surrender. It was all falling apart anyway. I could give in, let someone else deal with it. But it felt all wrong. Call it instinct, his posture, the way he held the gun. He was no friend. Shots ringing in my ears, I leaped for the hole in the fence and stumbled into the darkness beyond. A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
You can learn about nature and yourself.
Weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing.
Thank you.
The flare gun was probably the best weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing. It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, wake! You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
It's not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, I get you.
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
Thank you.
open the door now. They're gone.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon.
Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
I know it's hard to